The opening hymn is in number 267. Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Christ, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
Lord, have mercy upon us.
The Lord be with you.
With thy spirit.
Let us pray. God, who has prepared for those who love thee such good things as pass man's understanding, pour into our hearts such love toward thee that we, loving thee above all things, may obtain thy promises, which exceed all that we can desire, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated and listen attentively to the words of Holy Scripture. Thank you.
The Old Testament reading is from the book of Isaiah in the 57th chapter, beginning at the 13th verse. When thou criest, let thy companies deliver thee, but the wind shall carry them all away. Vanity shall take them, but he that putteth his trust in me shall possess the land and shall inherit my holy mountain. And shall say, cast ye up, prepare the way, take up the stumbling block out of the way of my people. For thus saith the high and lofty one that inhabiteth eternity, whose name is holy, I dwell in a high and holy place with him also that is of a contrite and humble spirit, to revive the spirit of the humble, and to revive the heart of the contrite ones. For I will not contend forever, neither will I be always wrong. For the spirit should fail before me, and the souls which I have made. For the iniquity of his covetousness was wroth, and smote. I hid me, and I was wrong. He went on forwardly in the way of his heart. I have seen his ways and will heal him. I will lead him also and restore comforts unto him and to his mourners. I create the fruit of the lips, peace to him that is far off, and to him that is near, saith the Lord, and I will heal him. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please rise for the reading of the psalm. The psalm appointed today is Psalm 85. Found on page 446 in the Book of Common Prayer, and we will respond at the aspect. Psalm 85, 446. Lord, thou art become gracious unto thy land.
Thou hast turned away the captivity of Jacob.
Thou hast forgiven the offense of thy people.
And covered all their sins.
Thou hast taken away all thy displeasure,
and turned thyself from the wrath of all the nations.
Turn us then, O God, our Savior,
and let thine anger cease from us.
Wilt thou be displeased at us forever?
And wilt thou stretch out thy wrath from one generation to another?
Wilt thou not turn again and quicken us,
that thy people may rejoice in thee?
Show us thy mercy, O Lord,
and grant us thy salvation.
I will hearken what the Lord God will say.
For he shall speak peace unto his people and to his saints, that they turn not again unto the foolishness.
For his salvation is nigh them that fear him,
that glory may dwell in our land.
Mercy and truth are met together.
Righteousness and peace are his each other.
Truth shall flourish out of the earth,
and righteousness shall look down from heaven.
Yea, the Lord shall show loving kindness,
and our land shall give their increase.
Righteousness shall go before him,
and shall direct his going in the way.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and shall be, world without end.
Amen. Please be seated for the reading of the epistle. The epistle is from the Apostle Paul's letter to the Romans, beginning in the 6th chapter and the 3rd verse. Know we not that so many of us were baptized into Jesus Christ, were baptized into his death? Therefore we are buried with him by baptism into death, that like as Christ was raised up from the dead, by the glory of the Father, even so we also should walk in newness of of life. For if we have been planted together in the likeness of his death, we shall be also in likeness of his resurrection. Knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin. For he that is dead is freed from sin. Now if we be dead with Christ, we believe that we shall also live with him, knowing that Christ, being raised from the dead, dieth no more. Death hath no more dominion over him. For in that he died unto sin once. But in that he liveth unto God. Likewise, reckon ye also yourselves to be dead indeed unto sin, but alive unto God through Jesus Christ our Lord. Here endeth the epistle.
Thanks be to God. The gradual hymn is hymn number 279.
Righteousness of the scribes and Pharisees, ye shall in no case enter into the kingdom of heaven. Ye have heard that it was said by them of old time, Thou shalt not kill. And whosoever shall kill shall be in the danger of the judgment. But I say unto you, that whosoever is angry with his brother without a cause shall be in danger of the judgment. And whosoever shall say unto his brother, Raca, shall be in the danger of the council. But whosoever shall say, Thou fool, shall be in danger of hell-bound fire. Therefore, if thou bring thy gift to the altar, and there rememberest that thy brother hath aught against thee, leave there thy gift before the altar and go thy way. First be reconciled to thy brother, and then come and offer thy gift. Agree with thy adversary quickly, whilst thou art in the way with him, lest at any time the adversary deliver thee to the judge, and the judge deliver thee to the officer, and thou be cast into prison. Verily I say unto thee, Thou shalt by no means come out thence till thou hast paid the uttermost farthing. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Is there anything else? Oh, we have our Veterans Breakfast coming up in 2 weeks.
Yes, the last Saturday of the month.
And we had a great turnout last month, 17 people. So we look forward to that ministry blossoming with everybody's help. And we have one more.
Just to let everyone know, we will be doing backpacks for the school at Atlantis for kids that are in need. And there's a list of supplies in the rear of the church. It is exactly 1 month away when school starts. So we need to get them filled in the next 3 weeks and deliver to the school so they can get to the kids that need them.
All right, I think that's it. The sermon then. Yes, ma'am.
Somebody, why don't you all need to do Carolyn and Father Mike's anniversary blessing?
Thank you. Believe me, we're running away from it. I need all the blessings we can get. Carolyn needs patience. Sermon hymn is number 263.
Work at banishing anger from the hearts of others. How does that compare
know, the words, the world's way of thinking. How often have we heard this kind of apology? Well, if anyone was offended by what I said, I'm sorry. I can't, of course, look into the hearts of those who speak those words. But it always strikes me that the message being relayed is really, I don't know why you have such a problem with what I said, but sorry, I guess. Compare that attitude with a close look at what Jesus said. If you were offering your gift at the altar, and there remember that your brother has something against you. The word translated as something could just as well have been translated as anything. In other words, if there's anything your brother is angry with you about, no matter how small, then go and be reconciled. Do we do that? Or do we instead say things like, oh, I was just joking. I don't know why he's so upset. He's going to get a thicker skin. No, Jesus says, it is not your brother who is the problem. The problem is yours. You've said or done something to upset and hurt another. Out of love for that individual, you need to go and set it straight. Offer a heartfelt apology without making any excuses. Resolve it when God reminds you. It's no accident that you were probably thinking about someone you're out of sorts with right now. Don't dismiss the ministry of the Holy Spirit at work in your memory. Remembering is the first step in reconciliation. It's God's way of prompting you to be a peacemaker. But does this mean that we should never say anything to hurt the feelings of another? No. The Apostle Paul was very clear when he encouraged the younger Timothy in Timothy's second letter to Timothy, preach the word in season and out of season. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with all long-suffering and doctrine. When we are wanting another one away from sin, we will have to rebuke and say things that may hurt that person's feelings. But we need to do it with love and caring. Why do you think Jesus urged reconciliation with a fellow sinner, even before approaching God in worship? What do your brother's attitudes have and feelings to you have to do with your relationship with God? Everything. If matters are not right between you and me, they cannot be right with God either. Bringing God a gift and spending time singing his praises doesn't give you the right to treat others in any way you wish to. They do that. Think of what Jesus said. Thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind. And then thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law of the prophets. These are both commandments. They are not just suggestions. Do we go out of our way to be reconciled with others? That takes work. It is usually just easier to shrug our shoulders and say, I don't know what her problem is, but I can't waste my time or energy worrying about it. What Jesus is saying this morning is clear. Look at how urgent the message is. Jesus says, agree with thine adversary quickly, whilst thou art on the way with him, lest at any time the adversary deliver thee to the judge, and the judge deliver thee to the officer, and thou be cast into prison. Verily I say unto thee, thou shalt by no means come out thence till thou hast paid thy uttermost farthing. The time for reconciliation must always be right now, not later when it's more convenient or easier. Now is the time to settle matters. Why is Jesus so adamant about this? Because tomorrow may be too late. Judgment day could come to you, while the person you have hurt may be called to glory. Jesus calls for anger banishment, not just in your heart, but in the heart of your brother or sister. We do not want to put off reconciliation with one another because we are all on our way to see the judge. Because God has reconciled himself to you through Jesus. We should go now and set matters right with any person you may have hurt. Banish all anger, not just from your heart, but the best of your ability from the heart of your brother and sister. Every second of our life that ticks away takes us one step closer to the judgment throne. So does that mean you shouldn't come to communion if you know something that someone has righteousness and anger against their heart against you? No. Come and pray to the Lord. Lord, I know that I've hurt this person. I'm sorry that I've done that, but I need your help and the courage to go to this person. I need your power. You will receive that courage and power through the blessing of Holy Communion. Come and ask for God's guidance. Ask for his love. Listen to his answer in your heart. God will give you the strength to do this. The person rejects your honest and heartfelt attempt to reconcile. Let them know that you are always open to talk and ask God to soften their heart. Again, it is no accident that you may be thinking of someone with whom you're estranged right now. Remembering is the first step to reconciliation. It is God's way of encouraging you to be a peacemaker. Thanks be to God.
Let your lights shine before men. They see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. Abigail as she recovers from her injuries, for continued Let us pray for the whole state of Christ Church militant here on earth.
Let us pray for the whole state of Christ Church. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications and to give thanks for all men, we humbly beseech thee to accept our alms and oblations and to receive these our prayers which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant unto those who do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also so to direct and dispose the hearts of all Christian rulers, that they may truly and impartially administer justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops and other ministers, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, especially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succor all those who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other adversity. Father Tim, Father Frank, Maddie, Father Wiley, Carrie, Pat, Deborah, Mike, Mary, Sonny, Rich, Frank, Debbie, Billy, Bonnie, Joe, Sandy, Ted, Jill, Marilyn, Julie, Joyce, Robert, the Monk family, Jessica, Michael, Eileen, Melody, John, Carrie, Rita, Marie, Anna, Jerry, Jason's family, Janet, Al, Steve, Lauren, Charlene, Brandon, Carol, Austin, Marilyn, Maddie, Don, Jill, and Abigail. For those traveling, Maria, Martin, Andrea. For those who are serving in the military, Jacob, Corey, Josh, Sage, Dean, Haley, Crystal, Karen, Christine, Dominic, Julie, James, Kyle, Johnny, Catherine, Andrew, Kendall. We offer a special prayer for Father Mike and Carolyn as they celebrate their anniversary this week. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear. Joy, Mickey, Dana, Robella family, Doria, Jason, Jim, Refugio, and the second anniversary of David Gouge's graduation to heaven. Beseeching them to grant them continual growth in thy love and service, and to give us grace so to follow their good examples that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant us, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
Amen. We do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and our love and charity of your neighbor, intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy ways. Draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession unto Almighty God, meekly kneeling upon your knees. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and do weigh of our manifold
sins and wickedness, which ye from time to time most grievously have committed by thought and word and deed against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and our heart is sorry for these our misdeeds. Remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in the newness of life, to the honor and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy have promised to give us our sins unto all those who with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And bring you to everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Savior Christ saith unto all who truly turn unto him. Come unto me, all ye who travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Hear also what St. Paul said. This is a true saying and worthy of all men to be received, that Christ Jesus came into the world to save sinners. Hear also what St. John said. If any man sin, we have an advocate with the Father, Jesus Christ the righteous, and he is the propitiation for our sins. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks unto our Lord God. It is very meek, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord Most High. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. O glory be to thee, Almighty God, O Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy to give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there, by his one oblation of himself, once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue, a perpetual memory of that his precious death and sacrifice, until his coming again. The night in which he was betrayed, he took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it in remembrance of me. Savior, Jesus Christ, we thy humble servants to celebrate and make here before thy divine majesty, with these thy holy gifts which we now offer unto thee, the memorial thy Son hath commanded us to make. Having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, rendering unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. We most humbly beseech thee, O merciful Father, to hear us.
and of thy almighty goodness, vouchsafe to bless and sanctify with thy word and Holy Spirit these thy gifts and creatures of bread and wine, that we receiving them according to thy Son, our Savior Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. I would earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses. I would earnestly desire thy fatherly goodness, mercifully to accept this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, most humbly beseeching thee to grant, by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we and all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we offer and present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee, humbly beseeching thee that we and all others who shall be partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, Jesus Christ, be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction, and may one body with him, that he may dwell in us, and we in him. And although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this, our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, or pardoning our offenses. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, be all honor and glory unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end.
Amen.
Let us pray. And now, as our Savior Christ hath taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his body, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him and he in us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takest away the sins of the world. Lord, I am not worthy that thou should come under my roof.
Speak a word, my soul shall be healed.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou should come under my roof. thou shalt come under my roof.
But speak the word only, and my soul shall be healed.
Lord Jesus Christ, just give me the word, and serve my body, and soul. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee that thou dost vouchsafe to lead us, have duly received these holy mysteries, the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are very members of the corporate and mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs to the hope of the everlasting kingdom by the merit of his most precious death and passion. We humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom be in the Holy Ghost, the honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Please stand and join me in saying Gloria in Excelsis. Glory be to God on high, and on earth peace and will towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee, we give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, Heavenly King, God the Father Almighty. O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. O Lord God, Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou only, O Christ, with the Holy Ghost, our most high and glory in God the Father. Amen.
Sir.
Father, would you have your oil stock with you?
Oh, wait.
And who takes this bride?
Consecrated the covenant of marriage, that in it it is represented in the spiritual unity between Christ and his church. Send therefore thy blessing upon these thy servants, that they may so love and honor and cherish each other in faithfulness and peace, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessing. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, world without end.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
The peace of God which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of Jesus Christ, his Son, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you, and remain with you always.
Amen.
Mass is ended. Report in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The recessional hymn is hymn number 301.
Thank you.
please join us for some refreshments, and as we have to run, but it's been a few seconds together, 2 minutes together, enjoying each other's company.